So I love winter squash, and when I found this recipe, I was really excited. Today we're making sweet meat chocolate chip cookies. So a couple nights ago, we cooked a sweet meat squash, and I had a little bit left over, looking around, trying to find something to do with it, and I came across a recipe for pumpkin cookies. And all of the winter squashes, pumpkin, Hubbard, acorn, sweet meat, they're all pretty much interchangeable in recipes. And so I thought I'd just throw the leftover sweet meat into these cookies. Here's what you're gonna need. Flour, baking soda, salt, cinnamon, nutmeg, allspice, butter, mascarpone, brown sugar, sugar, egg, squash puree, vanilla extract, and chocolate chips. So like I said, you could make this with pumpkin, you could make it with acorn squash, you could make it with Hubbard squash, you could make it with pretty much any winter squash. You just need the puree. Now you make these pretty much like any other cookie. You start out by mixing together the dry ingredients in a bowl, just whisk them together so that they're all incorporated. And you'll notice that this uses the classic pumpkin pie spices. Now in a stand mixer, you want to cream together the butter and the mascarpone and just get those well mixed together and light and fluffy. Next up, put the granulated and the brown sugar into the stand mixer and incorporate that with the butter and the mascarpone until they are all really light and fluffy. Once that happens, mix in the egg and beat that until it's fully incorporated. Now with the mixer still running, add in the vanilla and the squash puree. Once those are all mixed together, just slowly spoon in the flour mixture. Once you put in the last spoonful of flour, don't run the mixer too long. You don't want to overmix this. You just want to get everything incorporated. Now take it off the stand mixer and with a spatula mix in the chocolate chips. You could put in raisins as well if you wanted to, and or maybe some chopped walnuts or chopped pecans. At this point, you could put in a whole bunch of different things if you want to. Now this is a very sticky batter, so what I've done is put this in the fridge just to chill it down to make it easier to handle. Line your baking sheet with parchment paper. Hopefully you can cut parchment paper better than I can. And using an ice cream scoop, scoop it out onto the pan. You can probably only get about 6 on a regular size baking sheet. Remember, these are pretty sticky, so it's gonna take a little bit to make it happen. And once you've got them scooped out, just take the back of a spoon or your fingers or something and squash them down a little bit. Certainly helps if you put a little bit of water on your fingers or the back of the spoon. Now pop those into an oven and they're gonna take 13 to 15 minutes and you'll know they're done when they're a nice golden brown, and if you just lightly touch the top, it starts to spring back. Pull them out, let them cool on the pan and then put them on a rack to cool completely. So here we have it. And you know what, it's not a cookie in the traditional sense. It really is more like a muffin top. Crispy around the edges, soft in the middle, like a muffin top. We're gonna be having more of these.